Even Vice President Pence's chief of staff, Nick Ayers, would rather flee D.C. than work directly for Trump. Trump's anti-Midas touch now extends to the job of chief of staff, once one of the most sought-after positions in Washington, D.C. With John Kelly departing at the end of the year, Trump is reportedly having a difficult time filling the position because no one wants to work for a criminal buffoon who cabinet officials describe as a moron. Even Vice President Mike Pence's chief of staff, Nick Ayers, would rather leave D.C. altogether rather than take the gig. Trump had reportedly decided on Ayers, and the White House had even drafted the announcement naming him, according to the New York Times. But Ayers announced Sunday night that he may have political aspirations in his home state of Georgia, so he will not be taking over and will be leaving the White House altogether. A job that was once a ticket to Washington royalty has recently become a laughing stock, writes Politico. Trump's first two top aides, Kelly and Reince Priebus before him, have left as diminished and arguably humiliated figures, unable to control the wild chaos of this president's White House. Kelly and Priebus were most definitely humiliated in their departure. Priebus was famously shunned on an airport tarmac after Trump announced Kelly would take over. And Kelly reportedly had a deal with Trump to announce his own departure, but Trump, unsurprisingly, went back on his word and announced it himself. Increasingly shunned and isolated, pundits wonder who is willing to debase themselves as Trump's top aide. Politico reporters called around to gauge interest in the chief of staff position. They heard the same thing over and over again: no one wants it this time. The reasons are plentiful. Whoever takes over right now would likely be at Trump's side when Special Prosecutor Robert Mueller's report drops, when Democrats on Capitol Hill start hammering him, and as the market continues to slump. Politico adds, Mueller's investigation has already led to convictions and guilty pleas among several top Trump campaign aides and confidants. In a recent court filing from a Trump-appointed federal prosecutor, Trump himself is implicated in multiple felonies related to influencing the 2016 election. His longtime personal attorney, Michael Cohen, and several top campaign aides are cooperating with Mueller on multiple investigations. And with a new Democratic majority in the House of Representatives, Trump will no longer have complicit Republican lapdogs willing to help cover up his crimes. Of course, no one wants to jump on a sinking ship helmed by this corrupt, unhinged narcissist. Conservative pundit and never Trumper Rick Wilson often says that everything Trump touches dies. 2 years into his administration, anyone remotely qualified to be Trump's chief of staff knows this to be true, leaving Trump with just political dregs to choose from. When he looks around, Trump only has himself to blame.